student, in continuation with the chapter thermodynamics, today I am going to teach second law of thermodynamics, third law of thermodynamics. And then Gibbs energy, and spontaneity, and Gibbs energy, and equilibrium, right? These I am going to teach, and two sample numericals will be worked out based on Gibbs energy and spontaneity, Gibbs energy and equilibrium. With that, this chapter will come to end. Now let us see what is meant by second law of thermodynamics. In nature, most of the reactions occur in that direction wherein chances of increase in entropy takes place. So, second law of thermodynamics is connected with that. Right? All spontaneous processes take place in the nature. Right? And entropy, change in entropy of all these spontaneous processes is positive. Right? As spontaneity or spontaneous processes takes place, amount of randomness or degree of randomness, that is known as entropy, increases. Right? So always it is positive value. All the spontaneous processes which are taking place will have positive entropy value. Now come to second law of third law of thermodynamics. If you take a crystalline substance, so all crystalline substances will have particular pattern of particles aligned in them. Therefore, entropy in the case of those crystalline substances will be very, very less, minimum. But in the same crystalline substance is taken at 0 Kelvin, absolute 0 Kelvin temperature, then entropy of that crystalline substance becomes exactly equal to 0. Once again, in the case of matter, that is solid matter, again in that solid crystalline matter, if you take crystalline solid substance, since all the particles are arranged in a particular pattern, so change in entropy in such solid substances is very, very low. But same crystalline substance at absolute zero temperature, absolute refers to Kelvin scale, so at that temperature, change in entropy of a perfectly crystalline substance is equal to 0. That is third law of thermodynamics. Now come to Gibbs energy and spontaneity. What is meant by Gibbs energy and what is its relation with enthalpy and entropy at a particular temperature? And that process, whether it is spontaneous in nature or non-spontaneous. First, let us see what is meant by Gibbs energy. This is symbolically represented by the letter G. G for Gibbs energy. Now, what is meant by Gibbs energy? the amount of energy which is converted into useful work is known as Gibbs energy. For example, if we switch on electric switch, energy, electrical energy will flow and reach the fan. Once it reaches there, it is converted into mechanical energy and some work is being done by the blades of the fan, because all the three blades of the fan begins to spin when some work is done. So electrical energy is converted into work. If there is no loose connection, if loose connection is there, as and when we switch on electric switch, some energy in the form of heat will enter into atmosphere, means their electrical energy is wasted. According to Gibbs energy concept, energy should be converted into useful work. How much energy is converted into useful work? According to the concept, energy, whatever amount of energy is given to the system, that should be completely converted into useful work. That is said to be Gibbs energy. So here, energy, we can write in this way, energy converted into useful work is nothing but Gibbs energy. And change in Gibbs energy can be symbolically represented by delta G, change in enthalpy delta H, change in entropy delta S. And here Gibbs energy G is correlated with enthalpy and entropy at temperature T. So it is like this, H plus T S. Now change in free energy, if you take delta G is equal to delta H plus T into delta S, where delta G stands for change in Gibbs energy. Delta H, change in enthalpy. Delta S stands for change in entropy. So Gibbs energy means energy converted into useful work. Enthalpy refers to change in energy associated with a reaction at constant pressure, and entropy refers to quantum of randomness, degree of randomness of a particular system. So that's about descriptive part of this concept. And in this case, Gibbs energy and entropy are related in this way according to this expression. Now let us see Gibbs energy and equilibrium. How are these two correlated with each other? Gibbs energy is symbolically represented by delta G, that is known, and equilibrium constant in the case of any reversible reaction. Equilibrium constant is represented by K in some textbooks, reference books, KC is written. So we can write here either K or KC. So change in free energy of a particular process is equal to minus RT into natural logarithm of K. Let this be equation number 1. In this equation, delta G is known to us. R is universal gas constant. T refers to temperature on absolute scale or Kelvin scale. And in any expression, natural logarithm of anything, x, k, etc. Here it is k. So natural logarithm of k is equal to 2.303 log of k. Right? Let this be equation number 2. Here if we substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1, then equation number 2 is substituted. In equation number 1, we get delta G is equal to minus 2.303 log or T log of K. Let this be equation number 3. And here R value is equal to 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. And K stands for equilibrium constant. And as far as sign convention in connection to Gibbs energy is concerned, in the case of any reversible reaction, delta G, change in Gibbs energy, is equal to 0. If delta G value is minus, means in the numericals if we get delta G value, if it is associated with minus sign, then that shows the given reaction is spontaneous in nature. Means once the reaction is initiated, it takes place on its own, continuously. Next, if delta G value is positive, then that shows the given reaction is non-spontaneous. So we can write sign conventions in this way. When delta G is equal to 0, it shows the process is reversible in nature, or it shows the reaction is in equilibrium state. If delta G is negative, it shows spontaneous nature. Of the reaction. If delta G value is positive, it shows that the given reaction is non-spontaneous in nature. So that's about psych convention. So far I taught second law of thermodynamics, third law of thermodynamics, Gibbs energy and spontaneity, Gibbs energy and equilibrium. Let us see in short again. Second law of thermodynamics states that all the spontaneous processes takes place in such a direction where the entropy value is always associated with positive sign. Third law of thermodynamics states that in the case of perfectly crystalline substances at absolute zero temperature, change in entropy is 0. gives energy and spontaneity. Here, gives energy is delta G. Spontaneity refers to those processes which occur on their own once they are initiated. And it is mathematically correlated by G, H and S. G, H and S stands for free energy, enthalpy and entropy of the system respectively. And change in these free energy, that is Gibbs free energy, enthalpy and entropy, can also be written as delta G is equal to delta H plus T delta S. So here delta G, delta H and delta S stand for change in Gibbs energy, enthalpy and entropy respectively at temperature T. Capital T stands for absolute temperature. Next, as far as sign convention is concerned, in the case of any process, if delta G is equal to 0, then it shows the given reaction is reversible reaction. Means in that reaction, the reaction occurs in forward direction to give the products. Once the products are formed, again those products are converted into reactants. Means the reaction is not like the one-way traffic. Right? So that reaction should be reversible in nature. It should take place in both the directions. Next is Gibbs energy and equilibrium. In this, Gibbs energy and equilibrium, or Gibbs energy and equilibrium constant are formulated by the expression delta G is equal to minus RT natural logarithm of K. Right? Here, natural logarithm of K, if it is converted into log base 10, we get natural logarithm of K is equal to 2.303 log into K. This is second expression. When this is substituted in first, we will get delta G is equal to minus 2.303 RT into log K. And in this expression, R, it is constant and it is equal to 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Capital T stands for temperature on Kelvin scale or absolute scale, and K stands for equilibrium constant. Right, we will see numericals based on these two expressions, that is expression number 2. Expression number 3, that is delta G is equal to minus 2.303 RT log K. On the basis of this expression, we will see one sample numerical. And another expression is delta G is equal to delta H plus T delta S. On this expression also, we will see one sample numerical. Now, let us see two numerical, sample numerical. One numerical is based on delta H and delta U. That is delta H is equal to, that means the based on the correlation between delta H and delta U, delta NG at temperature T. Right? Another numerical is based on the correlation between change in free energy and equilibrium state at temperature T. Right, first let us see the data given. In first sample numerical. In this numerical, the change sin mi is undergoing is given. Means it is undergoing reaction with the dioxygen. So first that expression we will write, because delta NG value will come to know based upon the reactants and products of that chemical reaction. And that too, the number of moles of reactants and products, that is important. Then only you can calculate delta NG. For that we need to balance the equation and we need to know the physical states of reactants and products. Right? So that chemical equation we can write in this way. NH2Cn, when this undergoes reaction with dioxygen, it gives rise to nitrogen, which is there in gaseous form, plus carbon dioxide, that is also there in gaseous form, plus H2O, that is there in liquid form. And towards left hand side, dioxygen is in gaseous form. Cyanamide is in solid form. Here we have three oxygen atoms. So here I will write 3 by 2. Or 1 and a half O2. 3 by 2 means 3 oxygen atoms. Name of this substance is cyanamide. Now let us see the data given in this reaction. Delta U value is given, that is change in internal energy. Delta U is equal to -742.7 kilojoules per mole, and capital T is equal to 298 Kelvin temperature, and R value, here delta U value is given in kilojoules, so R value we need to convert it into kilojoules, and value of R is known in terms of joules, that is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. This is known to us. Delta U is given in terms of kilojoules. So either we have to convert delta U into joules or R value into kilojoules. Right? So this can be converted into kilojoules by multiplying with 10 raised to minus 3. So 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilojoules per Kelvin per mole. And delta Mg. Here the reactant solid cyanamide is in solid state. Water is in liquid state. These two we need not take into consideration. Only the reactant and the products which are there in gaseous form. That is what this G stands for. G for gas. So delta Mg stands for difference between total number of products minus total number of reactants, total number of moles of reactants. Once again, delta Mg stands for difference between total number of moles of products and reactants. Both should be in gaseous form. So total number of moles of products in gaseous form minus total number of moles of reactants in gaseous form. So here, total number of products if you take in gaseous form, 2 moles, 1 plus 1 minus reactant, only one reactant is there in gaseous form, that is 1.5 O2, 3 by 2 means 1.5, so 1.5, this is equal to 0.5 moles. When these correlate, we will get the equation in our mind, that is delta H is equal to delta U plus delta Mg or T. Now, if you substitute the values, delta U is equal to minus 742.7 kilojoules per mole into U. Plus delta Mg 0.5 into R value 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3. T value, that is temperature value, 298 Kelvin. So values are substituted and you will get answer around 741.5 kilojoules per mole. Directly I am writing the answer. This you can calculate and match with this. Once again, children, Here what is required to know is unit. Delta U, if it is there in joules, we need not change our value into kilojoules. We can keep 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole as it is. But delta U value is given in grams of kilojoules. Therefore, our value should be divided by 1000 or multiplied by 10 minus 3. Then we will get our value in terms of kilojoules per Kelvin per mole. So once we substitute, we will get the answer minus 741.5 kilojoules per mole. If it is 2 mass question, let us see the marking scheme, how it is divided. If you write the data till R, till the value of R, if you write the data, out of 2 mass, half mark is given to that. Next, half mark for delta NG, 1 mark over. Half mark for substituting the values. Half plus, 1.5 over. Remaining half mark is for the result plus unit. In that way, 2 marks are divided. Now let us see the second numerical, which is based on delta G. First, let us see what data is given in this numerical. The equilibrium constant for a reaction is 10. So, equilibrium constant means K. Equilibrium constant K is equal to 10. It doesn't have any unit. Simply, it's a unit. It's a number without any unit. Next, R value is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. And temperature value is given on Kelvin scale, that is 300 Kelvin. And here it is required to calculate delta G naught, that is standard. Gives energy or standard change in Gibbs energy, that is delta G naught. We need to calculate. So when all these are correlated, we will get the equation in the mind, that is minus 2.303 RT into log K. So minus 2.303 RT into log K. Now in this expression, RT and K values are known. Delta G naught is not known to us. So just by substituting and by doing multiplication operation, we can get delta G naught value. So delta G naught, so when values are substituted, right? So delta, we'll get delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303. R value is 8.314. T value 300 into log of K value, that is log 10. Here you need to know log 10 is equal to unit, that is equal to 1. So minus 2.303 into 8.314 into 300 into 1. Log of 10 is equal to 1. And this is equal to minus 5.744. Here, our value is given in terms of joules, so kilo joules. If I write minus 5744, that will be in terms of joules. So here what I did is that I divided by 1000. So I got in terms of kilojoules minus 5.714 or minus 5744 joules. Right? So that's about the solution of this unit. So that's about this unit, that is thermodynamics. Thank you, children.